How's it going, everybody? My name's Tori Source, and this is The Way of Life. I've played this a couple times before, or I should say tried to. The last two times I tried to record this game, the audio went out of whack and was just gone. I've had that trouble with a couple other videos. Some I salvaged, others weren't worth it. So hopefully this will work this time. Fingers crossed. If you just watched the Surgeon Simulator video, yes, this is the same day. I'm recording back to back. Unfortunately, I use open broadcast software to capture my screen, and I don't know why. I think because my laptop had restarted. So somehow that messed with the settings and my Yeti wasn't the default microphone anymore, so I apologize for the crap sound on that video. Let's start with the kid. Oh, I should probably explain, the concept of this game is kind of following the parallel lives of this kid, adult man, and old man. I'm not tired, why did my parents put me to bed? Probably are tired, bruh. Soccer, room for improvement. I like to play. Cool. Oh, teddy bear. So many memories. And soft. That's kind of creepy looking. Messy, fun, toys. Okay, this kid apparently doesn't think in coherent thoughts. Looks like a shadow. Fear. I assume he was reacting to the shadow and not the poster of the rubber ducky. Oh! Oh god. I have attempted this level before, and I kept falling, so I rage quit. So hopefully I'll have a streak of luck and just get through it. Blast through it. The problem is I start going too fast. Oh god. Oh god. And then I just tend to overshoot. Come on. Oh god, oh god, oh god. Little close. Okay. It's usually the close ones that screw me up, too. Okay. Because I either overthink or I just assume it's easier than it is. And it's a problem! I'm gonna turn this down really quick. Oh god, wasn't paying enough attention. This music is really intense and I cannot handle it. Oh man. This is what I mean. I wasn't paying enough attention because the music was too loud. Let me fix that really quickly. Okay. Because I need to be able to hear myself. Will I defeat it one day or will it haunt me forever? And then it comes back here. So let's try that again. Okay, I think this is the furthest I've gotten so far, so hopefully I don't fall off now. I'm gonna try going a little slower because I've definitely gotten ahead of the winged beast thing that haunts this kid's nightmares, which is pretty terrifying, you know. Got the ram skull going on. Oh man, there it is. Oh crap. I might not be able to beat this because I'm not good enough at these kind of trials where it's just you have to really time jumping, because I think I've said it in previous videos, I'm not a PC gamer, I'm a console gamer through and through. Pretty much, well, my family's had a Sony console, you know, PlayStation. I don't know why I said Sony console. Yeah, Sony console. Blah, 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 blah. We've had PlayStation since the first one came out. And we've been pretty on top of buying the newest edition of PlayStation as it comes out. And I've gotten to where third-person adventure-type games I'm pretty good at. But PC games, I just never could get a handle that well on the WASD controls or coordinating the mouse. I'm just really bad at it. Which begs the question, why did I start doing YouTube Let's Plays if it's easier and more affordable to do it with a computer? Which is a great question. Honestly, it's because I thought it would be a lot of fun to do. I started watching Markiplier after my dad got out of the hospital. He had leukemia. Wait, he still has leukemia right now. But, am I gonna make it? I hit the jump button! I hit spacebar! God! I'm gonna do this. I think talking really helped, actually. Maybe that's the secret for me, is just talk through it. Oh, man. Anyways, I started watching Markiplier after my dad got out of the hospital. He had APL leukemia, and he's fine now. He's in outpatient, and he'll be done in March, and there's no sign of it coming back, so he's pretty much in the clear. But I started watching Markiplier, and it was funny because the reason I started watching him, I had meant to, because I would very occasionally see GIFs of his videos on my Tumblr dashboard. And not often at all, because the people I followed just weren't really into YouTube gaming or anything like that, and I really didn't know about Let's Plays. Didn't really know that they were a thing. And I remembered seeing a GIF of when the 8 million milestone video came out. Someone posted something about, like, he's so precious, like, the fans made him cry, blah blah, that kind of thing. And I was like, oh, that's really sweet, he seems like a nice guy. Just kept scrolling, didn't really think anything about it. That made me want to look into it, but not enough to do it right then. What made me look up Markiplier on YouTube was when he did the Wharf Stash interview. Wharf Stash interviewed Mark. And all I saw from it was someone posted a GIF of when the microphone gets shoved in his mouth. And it was just one of the funniest things I had seen. It was so ridiculous. I was like, I have to watch this video. And I could tell that I was missing, I didn't really understand fully what was happening, because that, like, I hadn't been watching his other videos. I didn't understand who Wharf Stash was or why he was like that or anything. So I died. Anyways, that was the first Markiplier video I saw, but I knew I didn't really understand it, so I just looked up a bunch of his other videos, and I ended up watching, I don't think Five Nights at Freddy's was the first thing I watched, but I did look for his most popular videos to start with, so that was a really early one that I saw. No, I think it was, actually, yeah, now that I think about it, I think it was, because I remember remarking, I liked it because the way he responded to the game was how my brother and I act when we go through haunted houses. And I remember, even though I hadn't been watching Markiplier, I found the first video. Oh my god. I found the first video and told my roommate, and she had a friend over, and I went to show it to him, and I was like, you know, check this out, this is a new thing I found. And I remember the friend she had over made a remark about it seemed fake, like his reaction seemed fake, and I immediately got really defensive, because I was like, no, I, like, I act like this in haunted houses, I think this is a completely legitimate, like, he might be slightly exaggerating for the sake of the internet, but I think his fears, like, you can't fake timing like that, you know? And it's really weird looking back, because now he's, even, like, I don't know him, I've never met him, but he's one of my favorite people. And yeah, so I started with that, and then I made the mistake of watching Draw My Life, the 6 million milestone, and the 8 million milestone all back to back. Luckily, I was by myself in the dorm, in my room. My roommates were gone because it was a reading day. They had both gone somewhere, I forget where. And I just, like, bawled and ugly cried really, really loudly in my room. It was really late at night. And, yeah, that was when I knew, like, I just knew he was the best kind of person, and I really related, because his dad had cancer, and all these other things, and I was just like, oh my god! And yeah, that's why I started watching Markiplier, and if it hadn't been for watching— oh my god, I jumped too soon. Oh my god. Kill me now. I wouldn't have found out about Jacksepticeye or anybody that I watch now, and because of all of them is why I'm here doing this. And I figured it'd be a fun thing to do. I've always loved video games. I've always played with my brother and my dad, and I was like, you know what, even though I am not good at PC games, there are a ton of them and I want to get better, so why not document the experience? You know, I don't really care about having 10,000 followers or however, like, I am unbelievably excited at the fact that I have 7 right now, which to some people might sound really stupid, but you can ask my best friend. I update her every time I get a new subscriber. And even though it's like, it's 7, but that's just really meaningful to me, because it's no longer people that I went to high school with or that just know me for whatever reason. I don't know some of my subscribers. And if any of you are watching, hi, thank you for subscribing. It's really exciting to me. I don't know, I'm doing this for fun, and if what makes me happy makes other people happy and they like watching it, that's really cool. And I don't even know. I was just like, it's really cool, and I really appreciate that people like watching these videos, because even though, you know, none of my videos have broken 100 views individually yet, I don't really care about how many views they get. It's exciting to me watching the numbers go up, but I don't have, like, a number goal. I don't want to, you know, sit here and say, like, oh, well, within the year, you know, I want to have 500 subscribers and blah blah. Like, nah. Like, growth is exciting, and, like, I hope I have my channel grows, but this is just fun for me, and I wanted to share because I hoped other people would also think it's fun and entertaining. I don't know. I'm gonna try and focus now a little more, so maybe if I just stop overthinking the jumps, it'll just happen. I don't know. Well, maybe this is not my time, but hopefully this video works and you'll get to see it. If not, I don't know what I'm gonna do with this footage. If you like this video, like, comment, or subscribe. You can share with a friend. I think I want to do a series on it. That's why I got it. It's a free Steam game. And it's just really interesting. I want to get to the story part that threads these three characters together. And I think it's a cool concept. So I really want to play it and hopefully do a series on this. If you guys have suggestions for other games for me to check out,
don't bring me down.